Now then, today in the box is the Grundig Oxygen Concentrator. Let's give it a try.
Scroll down to read my review and please press like and subscribe.
Let's have a look now and see what else is in the box. Here's the UK power cable, but any sort of standard power cable can be used with an appropriate plug on the end. There's a car power converter, all separately sealed up. There's the remote control with all the key functions mirrored from the main unit itself. Here's a bag of spares, and there are two of everything, one pre-fitted. This is the Allen key used to remove the strap. Here's the first of the two breathing tubes. One goes into the nose and the other sits in front of the mouth like a sort of microphone. There's a carry bag for the main unit. A good detailed user guide. Now here's the car power converter with the UK socket and switch on the front, and that plugs into the car's cigarette lighter, and there's the carry bag for it, and again a user guide. Now then, let's do a test to see how loud this device is. I'm positioned about 5 feet away from the camera. The microphone is an on-camera shotgun mic pointing straight towards me. At the moment, the device is turned off, so let's turn it on and see how loud it is.
Oxygen on.
There we go. It's working away now, and it's at full power, which is giving out 90% oxygen and 1 litre. So now you can see how loud it is. Let's turn it off.
Oxygen off.
And the fan keeps going for a couple of minutes afterwards before it turns itself off completely. Now then, this device is designed to take the place of the external oxygen cylinders used for some types of health and beauty treatments. It's not designed for use in all cases, and if you have any sort of medical condition, you must talk to your doctor before using it. Now, the great advantage of this device is that it can output a 90% concentration of oxygen from a unit smaller, lighter and easier to use than the old style oxygen cylinders. Now, it does this by reducing the amount of nitrogen in the air, which it processes and then emits. Also, despite some reviews to the contrary, I've not found it excessively noisy. At 6.6 kilograms, it's no lightweight, but it's not too heavy or too bulky to carry, and it comes with a carry handle and strap to facilitate this. Now, it's mains powered, there's no battery option, but it comes with a power adapter so it can be used in the car, with the shoulder strap doubling as a seat belt to hold the device in place. Now, priced at £347, it's by no means inexpensive, but it's well made, transportable and easy to use. I'm not qualified to say how well it works, but to me, it all looks good. So I think, for the price, it's a rather a decent buy.